Episode 31, Eliza meets Eric's friends. Okay, Eliza, ready to meet my friends?
As ready as I'll ever be, Eric. Whoa, your dad wasn't kidding. Selene and Harold are goth people.
Wait a second, Selene and Harold Clandraft, who are those two right next to you?
My name's Sunobu Ichinoko.
And I'm Bridget Slatethorn.
Sunobu and Bridget are two of my best friends from Strident Street High School.
Right, Strident Street High School. I remembered hearing about that high school when Eric came back home from his first date with Jessica McIntyre. And I remembered hearing that he met you and Harold beforehand.
We sure did. We've also heard about him and his dad confounding the insurgency on the news.
And when we actually met Eric in person, he told us a little bit about all the stuff the Punishers did before they got sentenced to jail for 30 years 4 years ago. By the way, are you Eliza?
Yes, I'm Eric's half-sister. We share the same mom.
Wait a second. You're the daughter of the two co-founders of the most dangerous gang of child abusers in all of Rapper City.
Oops, sorry guys. That's one thing I forgot to mention. Almost half a decade ago, the Punishers escaped from jail and our mom married Boris. That's how Eliza was born.
Unfortunately, when I turned 4 years old, our mom and my dad abused me the exact same way they did Eric, Caillou, and their respective siblings.
Eliza, can either you or Eric tell us exactly what your parents did to you?
First, our mom woke Eliza up at 5:30 in the morning with an air horn like she did my sister Natalie. Then she punished her for being a sleepyhead with a hard-boiled egg for breakfast. And it's similar to when our mom gave me, most of my siblings, and our dad pancakes and gave Stephanie cereal while she had French toast because that's what she had with Boris. But when Eliza refused to eat her egg, our mom threatened to spank her, which she did anyway because Eliza asked her if she was crazy enough to spank her for refusing to eat it. And after when Eliza actually did eat the egg, Boris grounded her for being disrespectful, ungrateful, and a picky eater when he and her mom were really treating her unfairly. They even extended Eliza's grounding time from a whole day to a whole week all because she took a walk around the streets outside her apartment building where she was born.
Hold on, Eliza, you were born in an apartment building, not a hospital?
Nope. Our parents never even went to a hospital before I was born. They did this because they've been wanted fugitives ever since they escaped from jail with the rest of their gang.
Before you guys ask, I didn't know about the apartment building part until my dad first introduced me and my siblings to her. But aside from that, when Eliza watched the news about the Punishers under Croton Productions Incorporated's instructions, she called the police on our parents. And when Eliza interrogated our mom and told her the police are on their way to arrest her and Boris, our mom threatened to spank her, give her a concussion, and ground her forever. And when Eliza refused to turn around and bend over so that our mom could spank her, the psycho Karen herself threatened to give her an extremely brutal punishment day.
Oh. My goodness. That was the most horrifying thing I've ever heard.
No offense, Eric. But your mom's even crazier than we thought. I can't believe she would ever do that to a sweet and innocent little girl like Eliza.
I admit that everything Eliza and I just said was true, but she's not exactly defenseless. Shortly after when she ran away, she fought back against Boris. She even drop-kicked both him and our mom in the chest, jumped on her back, and challenged her to a fight. She's a highly skilled hand-to-hand combatant and a fast learner.
She can fight?
Yes. And actually, since I got grounded for a whole week for taking a walk outside, I decided to train myself in order to prepare myself in case my parents punish me again. And my fighting skills were passed down to me as an inheritance because both of my parents were Mad Dog veterans. And so were Officer Riggs, Mr. West, and Mr. Adamovich.
Wow, you're pretty tough for a four-year-old girl.
What can I say? My parents never saw it coming ever since I ran away from them. Anyway, Selene, Harold Clandraft, Sunobu, and Bridget, it was nice to meet you four.
You too, Eliza.
Whoa. How many goth friends do you have?
Actually, Eliza, we're not just goths. We're rock stars. My name's Rex Coulson. Right next to me is my girlfriend, Kai. Kylie Bautista.
Sup?
My name's Bruce Rudd.
And my name's Roger Armstrong. We are the Metal Dynamite.
Whoa, the Metal Dynamite? What kind of music do you guys play?
They mostly play hard rock music. Rex is the lead vocalist and lead guitarist of the band. Kylie and Roger are the backup guitarists, and Bruce is the drummer.
How do you know these four?
Eric met us 4 years ago. By the way, Eliza, Katie told me a little bit about you.
Ah, so you're Katie's half-brother.
I wish I could just say brother, but yeah, I'm her half-brother. Like you and Eric, Katie and I share the same mom.
You mean that your mom's as abusive as ours?
No, Rex's mom's the exact opposite of our mom.
Okay, Rex, something about how you and Katie are related to each other doesn't add up. If you two share the same mom and she's the kind and loving parent, who's the bad parent?
My biological dad, Rocky Lobowski.
What was that guitar riff for?
It was for Rex's dad.
So Lobowski was your surname by birth? Rex, I know this is gonna sound invasive to Katie, but what did your dad, this Rocky Lobowski, ever do to you that's considered child abuse?
The Nightmare Lobo himself smashed Rex in the head with his electric arm, his own son.
What? Dude, your own dad hit you in the head with a guitar? Why would he do that?
My band and I were rehearsing for a talent show that was held at Springfield at my family's old house at midnight. He thought we were planning to cause some mayhem.
Bruce and I had to help Rex up and rush him to the hospital while Roger kicked Mr. Lobowski out of the house.
Even though my dad was rough around the edges and as brooding as me, Rex's dad's much worse. That rock and roll Wolfie is a terrible father and a full-blown child abuser.
And trust us, kid, that guy can sometimes resort to using his own guitar, the Lobo 1500, as a weapon to discipline him.
Jeepers creepers. And I thought my dad was bad.
You mean the notorious Boris Anderson? The psycho-grounding father and co-founder of the Punishers?
Wait a minute. Did Rex's half-sister Katie tell you guys that?
Actually, Katie only told Rex. Rex, however, was the one who told us.
And Eliza, when Eric told the previous judge how much worse my dad was than your mom, I didn't expect her to treat you the exact same way she did him and his younger siblings.
I honestly didn't expect that either. But upon hearing what your dad, the one you were born to, did to you, I can totally understand why Katie didn't tell me or any of our friends.
I honestly didn't care whether or not Katie should tell you. I understood that when our mom told her, Katie felt sorry for me because she told me that you knew what it's like. I felt sorry for you too.
Same to you. But hopefully, this Nightmare Lobo doesn't break out of jail and hurt you or your mom or anyone close to Katie. My friends and I, along with the Justice Crows, we'll make sure of it.
That actually does make me feel better. Thanks, Eliza and Eric. Your half-sister is actually a totally brave hero and a very compassionate kid. She and those dogs of war made a bold move helping others out.
I could say the same about your half-sister.
Yeah. Anyway, it was nice to meet you, Eliza. But we'll be going now. We got a concert to rehearse for.
You too, Metal Dynamite.
These three are some of my friends from Unleashed Animations 1's channel, Harold Campbell, Ivana Gonzales, and Weston.
Nice to meet you, Eliza.
Wait a second. Eric, you have two friends who have the same first name?
What? Eric, you met someone with the same first name as me?
A few weeks ago, actually. His name's Harold Clandraft, and I just introduced him, Selene Emberdrifter, Sunobu Ichinoko, and Bridget Slatethorn to Eliza.
Talk about a coincidence.
Yeah, you're right about it.
Selene and Harold Clandraft actually went on a double date with Eric and one of his fellow insurgency crewmates, Jessica McIntyre.
Wow. Eric, you lucky dog.
You're a sly dog.
I agree with Ivana and Weston.
So how long have you three known Eric?
Since May 2023.
Wow. That's almost as long as the length of time Stephanie's been friends with Sage Martel and his crew.
Well, I get around a bit.
Yeah, but to be fair, Eric didn't make as much friends as Stephanie and Natalie. Aside from the friends they made in our creator's channel, they made a lot more friends than he did.
I actually remember Natalie being friends with Erica Dawson and Unleashed Animations 1's channel, but Natalie and Stephanie share some of the same friends as one another. Unfortunately, some of Stephanie and Natalie's friends were cheap knockoffs of characters created by your creator, as well as Raphael the Plotagon, Red Eagle 89, and TechnoGlitch.
Wait, are you talking about Zychromeo 07's characters?
Zychromeo 07? Who's Zychromeo 07?
Zychromeo 07's a menace. He's a McGoor, racist, a psychopath, a copycat, cat, a misogynist, and a homophobe.
How do you guys know that he's a copycat?
According to Red Eagle 89, Zychromeo 07 copied my dad's look and passed it off as a younger OC character of his own named Russell Peterson.
You mean to tell me that he's been plagiarizing characters made by other users and passing copycat versions of them off as his own?
Not just that. From what Natalie and her friends told me, he told someone in real life named Ellie Glamorous to go kill herself, made racial and homophobic slurs, and tried to kill his own OCs. He even faked his own death twice and accused a famous YouTuber named Davy Boy of faking his own death without any proof whatsoever.
You got to be kidding me. He really did all that stuff? What in the world is wrong with that guy?
Everything. And because of that, his parents forced him to close his channel and confess everything he did 4 years ago to everyone at his high school, and he got arrested for it.
Unfortunately, he returned to YouTube in March 2024 with a new channel.
What? He returned to YouTube a month after closing his old channel with a new one? Dude, everything he did is gonna take a much longer time than that for anyone to forgive him.
Exactly. Everything he did, even if he got taught a lesson by getting grounded by his parents, forced to come clean with everyone at his school, and arrested, is unforgivable. He just doesn't know when to give up.
Well, hopefully every single one of Rick's characters that Tune Productions Incorporated has ever featured in some of his videos so far will be kept out of harm's way.
As hard as it may be for any of us to believe, I sure hope so too.
Anyway, Eliza, it was nice to meet you.
It was nice to meet you three as well.
And these two are the last of my friends, Spring Martinez and Annabelle Dawson.
Annabelle Dawson. That's the only member of the Dawson family I haven't met.
Wait a second! You met the rest of my family?
First Eric's dad and Doris introduced me to your parents, then Stephanie introduced me to Zara, then Caillou introduced me to Zach, and then Natalie introduced me to Erica.
Wow, Stephanie and Natalie really beat me to the punch.
Yeah, I didn't expect that either. But it looked like your half-sister's got a really good memory.
See, Eric, I agree with Annabelle.
What can I say, Spring? From what Officer McShane told me and my dad, Eliza's smarter than an average child, almost as smart as one of her friends in particular.
Okay. Which amigo of Eliza are you referring to?
Jason Parker. I met him at Rapper City Elementary School after when I met the rest of the insurgency. Unfortunately, from what my principal told me, Jason has been getting bullied at home by his own dad, Gregory the Goliath Parker.
Wait a second. Gregory Parker, the guy who almost tried to beat Caillou up in order to get revenge on you for telling his son and Theodore on him and Dr. Stein respectively?
Yes. And I know this is gonna sound ironic given how small I am compared to that stupid gorilla, but I had to drag him all the way to Jason's house to have his mom ground him.
Jason's dad's really that big and stupid?
And a bully. None of us know why Jason's dad's been bullying him so much or why he couldn't stand his own child prodigy being smarter than him, but it's been happening for a while. And given how strong and muscular he is, making him able to give Jason a concussion for making his artificial intelligence name T6 for school, he's a very big guy. Not to mention that big jerk embarrassed Jason in front of Eliza and called my dad a puny little man.
When did he do that?
It was a few months ago when he grounded Jason for everything he does, including coming over to our house to help me with my science homework.
I mean, sure, Eliza could have asked either me or any of my younger siblings for help, but Jason's actually smarter than all of us. Plus, the little girl right here has a crush on the kid genius himself.
Eric, not in front of your friends. I've had enough trouble with Mr. Parker embarrassing Jason in front of me. Don't add to it.
Sorry, Eliza.
Oh, come on, Eliza. There's nothing embarrassing about a childhood crush.
Spring and Annabelle, you two don't understand. Our biological mom had a crush on Eric's dad when they were elementary school students. And they made out on school grounds. Yes, I may have a crush on Jason and vice versa, but I don't want to make the same mistake that she made when she was close to my age. Besides, our maternal grandparents grounded and spanked her every single day and sent her to military school the year Eric was born because of that. And between that and all the trouble Stephanie caused from 2015 to 2021, our mom's gotten stressed out, tried up to the point where she became a full-blown child abuser.
Eric, is everything that Eliza just said true?
It's hard to believe, but it's true. And we had to ground our mom every day because she gave Stephanie a concussion for putting bullet ants on Lily's chair and started a class riot. And our mom's been causing a lot more trouble in Carson Animate's channel than she did in Protoon Productions Incorporated and Dots' respective channels.
Your mommy's a child abuser? I thought she was a kind and loving mother like she was in my creator's channel.
Actually, Spring, she's not. Aside from the trouble Eric's mom caused in Dotson Carson Animate's channels, she also fat-shamed my dad and played ding-dong-ditch at her house. And from what Zara told me and Erica, that psycho Karen placed him and all of his siblings under spanking probation, skipped traffic, obstructed justice, and formed the Punishers. She even abused Eliza the exact same way she did all six of them.
Eric and Eliza, can either of you explain to me what this spanking probation is and what your mammy did to the other?
The spanking probation is a tyrannical household rule where she spanks either one of us for either disagreeing with her, disobeying her, and or doing something bad. And she only made two exceptions to those rules. 1. If my dad disagrees with her, she grounds him. 2. If we do something good, she spares us.
As for me, like she did to Natalie almost half a decade ago, our mom woke me up with an air horn at 5:30 in the morning. Then she wrongfully punished me for being a sleepyhead by giving me a hard-boiled egg for breakfast, and she and my dad refused to give me some of their French toast. Afterwards, she threatened to spank me for refusing to eat my egg, and she spanked me anyways for calling her crazy. And a week after we both our parents grounded me for taking a walk around the street outside of the apartment building where I was born, she gave me a triple punishment threat.
What do you mean by triple punishment threat?
In other words, when I first watched the news, discovered her true colors, and called the police on her, she threatened to spank me, give me a concussion, and ground me forever. And the last thing our mom did was threaten to give me an extremely brutal punishment day containing an infinite amount of punishments for refusing to let her spank me again.
So between running away from our parents all the way to the old Anderson house and my dad's old house, she had to hold her own against them and fought back.
But in the end, while Eric and the rest of the insurgency defeated the rest of the Punishers, including the psycho-grounding father Boris, Stephanie and Eliza defeated their mom.
What Eliza did back then was the bravest thing Stephanie has ever seen. She wasn't just a child prodigy, she's a hero, a born survivor. All that led to Eliza becoming not just the most popular girl in Rapper City Elementary School, but also the founder of a group of young heroes known as the Dogs of War.
Wow. Eliza, you are one brave little Nina.
I sure am, Spring. Anyway, it was nice to meet you and Annabelle.
You too, Eliza.
Eliza, about what I said about you and Jason, I'm sorry for saying it out loud in front of, well, any of my friends. I didn't mean to embarrass you in any way. In my defense, I knew she did everything that got her sent to military school when I first went to the forest outside of the city, though I have to admit, I had no idea our mom told you about her backstory.
She actually told me when I interrogated her upon watching the news for the first time. I felt sorry for her because of what happened when she was a child, but it didn't excuse her from abusing me, you, or any of us. I'm just glad I have a family who loves, supports, and protects me from any harm, even if I had to defend myself.
That's for sure.
Well, folks, I hope you all enjoyed watching me meet Eric's friends. If so, be sure to hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe to Protoon Productions Incorporated. This is Eliza Moreira Anderson, signing off. See you in the next episode, guys.